Good morning, guys. Now I'm going to say about secondary storage. Every computer needs a memory to store data and execute a program. That is called a memory unit. So in the memory unit, there are three types of memory. One is internal storage processor, and second one is memory, second one is primary storage, third one is secondary storage. Here now we are going to discuss about the secondary storage. Secondary storage is a device that we cannot access the secondary storage data directly. So we have to plug in a CPU that, and secondary storage, we have an advantage is we can carry the secondary storage to anywhere we like. So now in that secondary device, I am going to explain one of the type of device, that is optical disk. Optical disk. An optical disk is an electronic data that used to storage medium that can be written and read from using low power laser beam. And this was introduced by James T. Russell. Here, one of the most advantages in optical disk is the data is stored in binary form. And it is having the, in optical disk, generally we can see in optical disk that we have a laser light of beam in the optical disk backside. So that is known as the data. And classification of optical disk. Optical disk is classified into basically five types. One is CD-ROM and CD recordable, CD rewritable, DVD-ROM and laser disk. And now we are going to six. The first generation came into action of 1980s. So optical disk, what is optical disk? The technology exploited to possibly using digital representation of analog sound signals. That's analog signal was taken in a rate of 44,100 samples per second. First version. The first version was came as CDs. Here in CD we can store a memory up to 75 minutes, and here we can see the CD requires approximately an order of magnitude and more bit storage. So more bit storage capacity than that of audio CDs, and it can store the large amount of data. It can show the large amount of data than the disks. And optical technology that was used in CD systems on the basis of laser light source, and a laser beam is directed onto the surface of the spinning disk, and this reflects the focused light on the photodetector, which detects the stored light in patterns. And coherent light consists of synchronized waves and that have the same wavelength. And here are the layout of the optical disk. And here we have the polycarbonate plastic, and here 125 mm of discs, and here the main parts is aluminium, acrylic and label. Here the size of the disc will be 12 mm, and the bottom layer polycarbonate plastic for clear the glass base. And we know then generally optical disk will be having upper has a optical glass disk, and before and in the middle we will be having one round disk which has a 12 mm of size. And in optical disk, if we see backside, we will be having some moving laser in the disk, and that will be known as the storage of data. That and here the storage will be of data will be having of in bits of binary. And here the storage disk will be having the total thickness of 1.22 mm, and the emitted ray travels in this plastic device that is nothing but disk, and the emitted beam travels through this plastic, and disk is totally scanned by the laser light. If we insert a disk into the CPU, the disk will be first scanned by the laser light coming from the CPU, and then the data will be displayed on you in digital way, and that is in monitor. And now the light reflects in the pit solely from the lamp, and the detector will be seeing the reflected beam as bright spot. We will be having a bright spot on the disk on the back side of the laser beam, and that bright spot is known as a data, and that will be shown you on the screen. And if there is a opposite wave reflected from each other, then the wave will be cancelled and the data will be not shown. Here is optical disk classification, and here you will be having, you already seen the before shown that cross section of the disk. Here we will be knowing pit, land, aluminium, polycarbonate, plastic, acrylic label. And when the source of light that is from the CPU is coming on the
disk and heating, then it will be detected and the data will be stored in the binary form given here. And same in the process is going on for the transition from pit to LAN. Pit means that which was the disk we have inserted, and LAN means the data which we are describing in the system. And this will be showing you the total structure of the optical disk transition. And each transition, each disk transition is stored in the special bright spot, and it is taken to denote a binary value. Now we just discussed about binary value, ones and zeros, it will be stored in the, represent in the position, and it will, the laser beam spot will be detected in the form of binary pattern. And here we can see the total overstructure of the, and here we can see the oval structure of the CD. Diameter of the CD is 120 mm, and the hole at the center, will be 15 mm, and data is stored in the tracks and cover the area from 25 mm to 58 mm. Here we can like continuous records up to 800 to 2000 tracks of centimeters of data. And here in the floppy disk, we have only 40 tracks of data, and here we can store up 800 to 2000 tracks of the centimeters of data. And here we can say that CD is more useful to store data. Here there is another type of optical disk called CD recordable. In CD recordable is nothing but CDR with the short form of writing disk, and CDR is nothing but compact disk recordable. It is a digital type of disk where we can store data at once and can be readable for many times, but we cannot erase the data from this recordable once we store the data in it. See, now CR disk is a readable most plain CD readers, that is CD readers is manufactured in the introduction of CDR. This is an advantage over the CDRW. CDRW is nothing but compact disk rewritable, and which can be rewritten but cannot be played many plain times of CD readers. And the storage capacity of the disk is 74 minutes. That means approximately we can say as approximately 1.2 GB up to that. And CDR and CDRW are available for capacities of 80 minutes of audio and 737 crore 288,000 of bytes of memory. That means 700 MB, which can be achieved molding of disk and tightest allowable tolerances specified the Orange Book CDR or CDRW. Now this is the image of CDR and CD erasable and CD rewriting. Here we can see the diameter of a disk will be 120 mm, that means nothing but 12 cm, and in inner diameter is 1.2 mm, and the thickness is also 1.5 mm, where we can store data. Here we can see some laser light of beam that is called nothing but data. In behind the laser beam we will be having one brightest spot, and that is called as data we have stored in it. It will be stored in the 1 and 0's binary form. And now here we are going to see about another disk, CD rewritable. And CD rewritable stands for compact disk rewritable, and it is a compact disk that can be recorded or erased for multiple times and can be seen for us. This is mostly used for stored music and videos and movies, something which related to you. And this disk can be used in an optical disk. This technology was introduced to us in 1997. And a CD rewritable disk is a compact disk that can be rewritable and read attributely and many times, and can be erased and can be written again. This is widely used in before generations, not here now. And memory capacity of CD rewritable. The memory capacity of a rewritable is 74 minutes, as we have discussed before, the audio capacity or video capacity, and it has a 650 megabytes of data and are available with capacities of 80 minutes. And nowadays it has been, technology is improved, and we can be going to get up to 1.2 GB type. And same we have discussed about 120 mm of diameter of the disk, and the storage capacity is about 74 minutes to 80 minutes of data. The CD readable can be rewrite up to 1000 times only, not more than that we can go. That also we have got latestly. DVD technology. DVD means digital versatile disk.
And this word DVD was, it can be store a full length of movie, that can be said about DVD disc. And thickness is 1.2 mm and diameter is 120 mm. And it has large capacity than the CD. What? It has large capacity than the CD. We can store more data than up to 1.5 GB like that. And here we can see the minimum length of a pit in this DVD is 0.4 micron. And tracks are placed closer between, closer to each other, so we can store more number of data. And each track, the distance between each track will be 0.74 microns. And a red light of wavelength is 6635 nanometers of IR. And the IR means infrared radiation. And shorter wavelength is possible. Short, if we have shorter wavelength in the CD as a label laser beam, so we can access the data easily and can be loaded fastly. This manufacturer expresses disc in DVD. As we have discussed before, in CD and DVD also we have DVD readable and DVD rewritable. And this DVD RAM is a disc which has 4.7 GB in a single dime and 9.4 GB in a double-sided disc and 1.46 GB in a single and 2.92 GB in a double-sided disc of 8 cm and 12 cm. There is a change in only in the CD capacity. We will be having CD in a shorter way and long way. And here we have the differences between this, and here we can see the data. And DVD RAM is a rewritable version of DVD, and it has a larger storage capacity than the CD. And disadvantages is that it has higher cost, and we cannot write fastly as DVD, as before we have discussed about DVD and CD. Here we can write very slowly and we can store more memory than the CD, and the cost is also more. This is the only disadvantages in this. And it is stored contents and checks them again as the original stored contents and checks them again as the original data. And thank you guys for giving this opportunity.